I'm Dr. Asin Singh, working as a senior consultant neurosurgeon in Apollo Gleneagles Hospital, Kolkata. Today I'll be talking something about the epilepsy, which every people should know the basics of epilepsy, because the many populations of our country are suffering from this disease. As we know, our brain is a complex organ and made of many specialized brain cells. These brain cells perform electrical activity, which occurs in normal patterns and are responsible for normal functioning of the brain. Epilepsy is a disorder where the brain cells starts throwing recurrent, sudden and episodic bursts of these excess electrical discharge, and which results in the behavioral pattern of the epilepsy. However, as we know, the seizure disorder is basically a single episode, and whereas epilepsy, where there is multiple attacks happens in patients. Now, the different types of epilepsy is electrical abnormality of the brain, and some electrical can start in a small area of the brain and spreads the whole brain. How to diagnose epileptic attacks or the seizure disorders? So basically, there are certain combination of symptoms by which we come to know that epilepsy patient is suffering from epilepsy. Like it has a beginning or middle and end. Different symptoms can different times, and symptoms also depends upon the area of the brain involved. The patient may have a small slight steering loop, jerking movement of the arms and legs, suffering of the body, tongue bites, loss of consciousness, lot of bladder and bowel functions, failing suddenly to an apparent reasons, especially when associated with loss of consciousness, not responding to noise or word of brief periods, and appearing confused or in a stage. Blinking and staring, that may be the one of the signs of epilepsy. And during the seizures, person's lips may become bluish and breathing may not be normal, and the movement are often followed by a period of sleep or disorientation. Symptoms of seizures may resemble other medical conditions. It should be always consulted by the physicians for a proper diagnosis. There are the various causes of epilepsy. The reason depends upon what the patients are suffering from. Like it can hemorrhage in the brain, the trauma to the brain, the infection inside the brain. There is a certain congenital abnormalities which can cause epileptic attacks. Next. Sometimes there is a strong family history of epileptic attacks that may run through the family. And the frequency of attacks, these of epileptic attacks, may be frequent or more in a day, or it may happen in a weekly basis, or it can happen once in a year. So usually they are very difficult to predict the number of attacks in particular persons. There are certain trigger factors by which we can assess that which patient is going to have the attacks. Like the patient has not taken medicine in the proper time, the stress, the lack of sleep, menstruation cycle, that can also trigger these epileptic attacks. In this, both with or without fever, heavy use of alcohol or other drugs, or frequent smoking. The trigger can be avoided to prevent epileptic seizures. So the one has to know about his own seizures to prevent epileptic attacks. Early diagnosis is very important, because if you diagnose this case early, then the treatment is instituted early in his life and it can be controlled better in the later life. And the diagnosis always depends upon the nature of the attack, which the person or the family members can very well tell about the incidents and doctor's diagnosis on that basis. Or there are certain blood investigations, imaging techniques like CT scan of the brain, MRI of the brain, and finally EEG can prove that there is some electrical discharge in the brain. Treatment is variable, and various drugs are available to manage these conditions. A specific treatment of a seizure will be determined based on the medical history, the type, frequency of the seizure occurrings, related illness, and a level of tolerance. Based on your condition, the doctor may prescribe one or multiple drugs, and the dose of drugs may increase over the time till the control is achieved. So regularity and the regularity of taking the drugs and the proper management is very, very important to control epilepsy in a particular patient. Thank you very much.